and corruption. Communalism is about one particular group of religion people feels that their religion is greater to all. So communalism once had shown a disastrous result in India, that is a partition of India into the Indian Union and Pakistan. So in this period we find religion involvement into the political issues. A new kind of political mobilization which is based on communalism, that is religion, started here. And here this communalism in politics created disastrous results that questioned the unity and integrity of the nation. One important issue we discussed here in 1985, Supreme Court judgment on the case filed by Shabano. Shabano, who wanted her maintenance, put up a case on her ex-husband. The court has given the judgment that husband should bear the maintenance or the maintenance of her wife, who received a divorce from a husband, right? So what happened here in Muslim, two sections we have seen. One is Muslims who wanted to change in their community and culture along with the changes taking place in the modern world. What we call progressive Muslims, who wanted to bring changes, reforms in their community, are called progressive Muslims. Progressive Muslims have welcomed, accepted the judgment of the Supreme Court. But what we see here, other sections of the Muslims who have been sticking to their culture and religion very strong, they opposed it. That is what you call orthodoxy Muslims. What we call orthodoxy Muslims. They stood up against the court judgment and they stated that there is a involvement in the Islamic law by the court. So Islamic law, it is the judgment of the Supreme Court was against their Islamic culture. If that court judgment is allowed, so in future the interference of the court into the religious life will increase. That is their fear, orthodoxy Muslims. And here we see that certain leaders who raised a women's movement, they stood up for reforms in the Muslim society. Some of the leaders who supported the women's movement for their equality and their development, women's development, they wanted that certain reforms to be introduced in the Muslim society. So they felt that the reforms introduced in the Muslim society would help to the Muslim women who had been facing the injustice from ages onwards. In Muslim community, there was a trend where husbands unilaterally given divorce to their wives. That was the injustice. Without taking the opinion of wives, husbands have gone for taking divorce from the wife whenever they want, instead. So that is a unilateral decision, right? So the government came under the pressure when Supreme Court has given the judgment that Shabana to be paid maintenance by her husband. So there the Muslim community people, they increased pressure on the government to avert the judgment of the court. So there the Congress government, it has come in the grip and force of the orthodoxy Muslim and passed an act in 1986. That act says that instead of husbands, the Muslim religious bodies were given responsibility to pay the maintenance to divorced women for a period of 3 months. So when this act passed by the Congress government, this passing this act by government was seen by public as a compromise between the orthodoxy Muslim and the government. So there the government came down and bent towards orthodoxy Muslims, where government ignored the interest of the women of Muslim community. So here politics, we see they taken the issue of the religion. That means in politics, religion have entered and it turned to religious politics. Okay. Government wanted the support of one particular community in the next elections. Right? So to win the next election, it is essential to get the support of the people, so that the government stepped down and passed an act in favor of Islamic law. So we see here religious involvement in the politics. Okay. That means religion should be separate from the politics. This religion entered into the politics. That means religious mobilized politics started in India, which very danger to the national integrity and unity. Another example we see on religion political mobilization, that is Lord Rama temple that we have seen in the last class. Hindus have begun for constructing Lord Rama temple at Ayodhya. So here Lord construction of Lord Rama temple become a controversial thing between two communities, Hindus and Muslims. The time it broken the relations between Hindus and Muslims. Near about more than 30 years, this case was in the Supreme Court. Finally, in 2019, we have got the judgment. So, in favor of the construction of a Lord Rama temple. Okay. So during that time, there Babri Masjid, where Babri Masjid, there they wanted to construct Lord Rama temple. So there that issue went to the court. So court has given a judgment in 1986. The 86, the court ordered that mosque, that is masjid, it may be kept open for on all the days and allowing the Hindus to worship on daily basis. So there it was believed that how it has happened, just it is because of central government. Central government approved for this decision that opening of a mosque for Hindus and Muslims. Understand? So this opening of the temple helped those groups who wanted to convert mosque into temple. That means Hindus. It helped the what Hindus to convert it to a temple, because already at Lord Rama temple existed there where Babri Masjid is constructed. By converting Lord Rama temple into Babri Masjid as per the historical evidence, right? So here, for too many observers, it appeared that these political parties which established a government there, they losing the popularity. They have come into the grip of a religion. So for the religious aspects, political parties bended, right? And another issue we see here, that non-political movements also started there. That is large farmers, what you call, producing for a market, they raised a fight for better price for agriculture products. Farmers were not gaining better price for their agriculture products, so they raised a movement. This is a non-political movement, okay, understand? And they wanted a great subsidy for their requirements, agriculture requirements, for diesel. They wanted some subsidy, fertilizers, and even for electricity. So this started in UP, farmers of UP, that is Uttar Pradesh, Haryana. They have started an agitation under the leadership of Mahender Singh Shikayat. This is in Uttar Pradesh and Haryana. And farmers in Maharashtra, they too started an agitation demanding for better price for agriculture products under the leadership of Sharad Joshi. This is movement related to the farmers, non-political movement. Another side, we see some other movements started by people living in forest area, that what we call movements of Adivasis. Movements of Adivasis and farmers. There the government decided to construct developmental projects. Sardar Sarovar Dam, government planned to construct where Adivasis were living. So Adivasis were going to displace by Sardar Sarovar Dam. Okay, so they raised a movement against construction of dams and developmental projects. This is a movement of Adivasi. Instead, we see Adivasis were losing their right on the places where they are living from ages onwards. So many of the people felt that this decline in popularity, that political parties come down, they become unpopular, coming to the grip of a religious matter that created problem for national unity and integrity. So the observers felt that this decline popularity led for national political parties to come into the grip of religious feelings, either to the Muslims or Hindus. Some of the political parties have come under the grip of a Hindu community, and some other political parties stood up for the interest of Muslims because they wanted to get the support of these communities in coming elections. Understand? So politics have become religious politics. Political parties have gone fulfilling the religious matters of the people. So religious politics started in this era, and this religious politics have widened the gap between Hindus and Muslims. Understand? So it weakened our secular fabric of Indian polity, and that led to what a rise of communal politics for the next 10 years. It means Hindus stood up for constructing Lord Ram temple, where the authorities of Masjid, they wanted to protect Masjid. Understand? So this sensitive issue created trouble and led for taking the lives of both communities. Understand? And around this say time, we see their corruption also started. So religious politics started where communalism entered into the politics, and along with the communalism, with the religion, corruption also started. Okay. At that time, our Indian government made an agreement with the Swedish government to supply the latest guns for our Indian army. So some of the leaders of our Indian government, they received bribes from Swedish manufacturers, what to call, making our government to get Swedish guns from Swedish manufacturers. So some what to call MPs at that time, they received bribes from the Swedish manufacturers in giving agreement, that is what to call tying the agreement with the Swedish manufacturers. Our Indian leaders helped to the Swedish manufacturers for supplying the guns for Indian army. Understand? So here many of the political leaders and MPs of the Vishwanath Pratap Singh government, they involved in corruption. So charges have been filed on these corrupted leaders, but they did not take action on it. So this corruption in the administration and in the political circles become very important for elections by non-Congress parties. Non-Congress parties have shown the corruption and religious politics are the two important points for non-Congress parties to win elections. When elections were going to take place, at that time, non-Congress parties have raised that many of the Congress leaders involved in corruption to decrease the popularity. Congress have bent towards certain community people for protecting their religious interest. So these two issues, that is corruption in the administration and religious matter in the politics, become main plank for non-Congress parties in coming elections. Understand? So at around this time, we see that in 1989, when elections were announced, Congress party was not able to get a majority. non-Congress parties. Many of the non-Congress parties united, keeping their differences aside to defeat the Congress instead. So it become very difficult for Congress party to win the elections in 1989. Okay, Congress failed to get a majority in the sense, you know, magic figure is required to form the government. So magic figure, Congress failed to get the magic figure, but it formed the government by merging with other political parties to raise a magic figure. Understand? So Congress returned to power with the highest number of seats, but it did not get a magic figure to form the government. So here we see first time in 1989 there coalition government started in India by V.P. Singh's Vishwanath Pratap Singh, who belongs to the Janata Dal party, declared as a seventh Prime Minister of India. Understand? So here in India we see that coalition era started. That means governments formed by various parties collectively called coalition government. Okay, when no party gets a majority in election, at that time some of the political parties will come forward with mutual agreement to form the government. Such governments are called coalition governments. Understand? So here in 1989 we see that there the coalition government started because the Congress did not get a majority. Understand? So two significant changes happened in India after 1990s. One is we have seen that our democracy started with a single party. For 30 years Congress ruled, right? From 1947 to 1970 it was the rule of Congress party, single party dominance, one party dominance was there, and we shifted from one party dominance to multi-party system, especially competitive multi-party system. Right, today we see that many of the political parties are competing to come into power. In that competition, no party is able to get a majority, that is a magic figure, and coming to form coalition governments. Today we see that coalition governments. Now it is BJP ruling is not a coalition, that is own government. Understand? Several coalition governments started by 1990. So it is the great transformation in India from one party dominance to multi-party system. This is the significant change we got in our Indian politics. Understand? So what is coalition government here? Understand? So it become impossible for any party to win a majority of the seats for forming the government. So from 1989 all governments that had formed at national level are coalition governments or minority governments. Understand? After 1989 in India we see that at national level, at union levels, at central level, the governments formed are coalition governments, right? So what is a coalition government here, right? It is that various political parties coming to form a government with mutual understanding, right? When no party gets majority seats, then some political parties will come together to form the government at a national level or at a state level is called coalition government. So at that time, number of national and regional parties had come together to form the government at the center. That what we call coalition government. So what happens in the coalition government? It means that political ideologies and programs of a number of parties had to be accommodated and a common agreement had to be arrived at. See, various political parties are united to form the government. So for every political party, there is a specific political ideology and program. So irrespective of their own political ideology and program, they have to come for one common agreement, right? So it is very difficult to come to a common agreement by various political parties which formed a government, understand? So here we see that in collegial government, it is very difficult to run for 5 years of a period. So here no party could pursue its extreme agenda. For every party, there would be one specific agenda, and that specific agenda cannot be executed because it's a coalition government in which other political parties are also sharing the power. So when other political parties are sharing the power, they should be convinced to come for a common agreement. So it's very difficult to bring all the parties to come into a common agreement, understand? So that the coalition governments did not run for 5 years. It may collapse after 1 year or 2 years, understand? As they did not get majority, we call that coalition governments with minority government also, understand? So here we see that these coalition governments may break for any sensitive issue also because of diversified view points, understand? So where the coalition governments formed by various political parties, they may not come for one conclusion and one decision in a short period. There we find delay in implementing the policy by coalition government. As there is delay in the coalition government in implementing the policies, that what we call here policy paralysis. What we call policy paralysis. What is by policy paralysis? That the coalition government may not implement any policy due to the differences in the opinions by various political parties. So there may not be outcome from the government, understand? Government makes negligence here, because if it implements a policy on its own, there may be chance of other political parties which are giving support to the government may withdraw, right? So some of the political parties which are not supporting to the government, they may withdraw their support from the government. So there we see that the political parties which collectively formed the government, they feel insecure, and they may think that small parties may go for withdrawing their support on certain issues, so that there will be delay in policy making. And the delay in policy making by coalition government is called policy paralysis, understand? Because there we see that any party may go for withdrawing the support. When a particular party withdraws its support, then the magic figure will come down. The majority seats, it has to lose. So the party which has lost its majority is not allowed to run in the power. It has to step down. So the government falls from the power. Understand? So minority governments or coalition governments did not run for long period. If it runs for long period, then we can say that it is a very great government. Understand? Right? So here, while the early coalition governments were highly instable, that means they did not run for long period, and they did not run for their full term, that is 5 years. Later, the early coalitions, that means in the 1989, whatever the coalition governments formed, they did not run for long period. Then after 1990s also, we find governments formed at national level or coalition governments, which are called later coalition governments. And these later coalition governments, they used different mechanisms to run their coalition government up to their full term, that is 5 years. Okay, so there are some multiple mechanisms used by coalition governments to run their coalition governments for a period of 5 years. Understand? What are those? Common minimum programs. Understand? Common minimum programs introduced in coalition government to keep cooperation and support for running the government. Another is coordination committee. This coordination committee removes diversities in the opinions about the partners who formed the government. Okay, so there would be coordination committee. Later, what happened in coalition governments? They established a coordination committee. This coordination committee will go on removing the differences among the partners who are in power. Understand? So coordination committee, common minimum program, these are the mechanisms used by the later coalition governments to complete their 5 years of a period. Okay, so lateral coalition governments have succeeded in completing their 5 years of a term. Such a successful coalition governments are two. One is a National Democratic Alliance, that is NDA. This is led by BJP. Another is a United Progressive Alliance, in short UPA. This is run by Congress. So National Democratic Alliance led by BJP, United Progress Alliance led by Congress. These are the two major coalition governments we see they succeeded. Understand? The first UPA government, UPA coalition government re-elected. Once the UPA, United Progress Alliance with the leadership of Congress, come into power and completed it 5 years of term. Again, it re-elected by the people with the leadership of Manmohan Singh. So two times we see UPA formed the government, that is a coalition government, and that run successfully. Now BJP leading the what? National Democratic Alliance, NDA. It is